Your candidates for the most important office in the free world seek your concern, your thoughtful judgment, and your votes in this vital campaign of 1960. Senator John F. Kennedy of Massachusetts, selected by the Democratic Party after 14 years on the national scene, began his campaign for the office of president with the same energy he displayed in seeking the party nomination. Entering seven state primary elections, he won them all and went to Los Angeles in July with an overwhelming lead of the votes pledged. His nomination on the first ballot capped a political career of 6 years in the House of Representatives and nearly 8 years in the Senate. With his mother and one of his sisters, he received the cheers of the convention. Kennedy's record in the Senate includes a leading role on committees ranging from labor management relations to foreign affairs. He has been a moving force behind major legislation. His wife Jackie accompanied him while he voted in 58 when he was re-elected to the Senate. In 52, he first demonstrated his unusual vote-getting ability by winning in Massachusetts despite the national trend. For his running mate in 1960, Kennedy chose Lyndon B. Johnston, leader of the Senate majority. As far away as West Berlin, the Kennedy campaign has been carried on vigorously, appealing to all eligible voters, including GIs, who vote by absentee ballot. Kennedy and his wife have a 2-year-old daughter, Caroline, and Mrs. Kennedy is currently expecting the birth of a second child. At Chicago last July, Vice President Richard M. Nixon was viewed almost unanimously as the Republican Party's natural successor to Dwight D. Eisenhower. His wife, Pat, his mother, and his daughters, Tricia and Julie, were with Richard Nixon as he received the ovation of the delegates. His running mate, Nixon, chose Henry Cabot Lodge, ambassador to the United Nations and holder of a cabinet post, a fellow member of the Eisenhower team. The ticket was enthusiastically endorsed by the president. As vice president, the Republican nominee has extended the role of the office beyond that of any vice president before him. With leading cabinet members at home, and as the president's representative abroad, he has helped formulate and carry out United States policy. In Poland, his popular reception demonstrated that the spark of freedom was still alive in that communist state. He was cheered on his visit to the ruins of the infamous Warsaw Ghetto. The U.S. Fair in Moscow, the Nixon-Khrushchev debate in a model American kitchen attracted headlines around the world. Nixon achieved the unprecedented opportunity of speaking directly to the Russian people. Also a vigorous campaigner, the vice president set out with his wife to reach every corner of the U.S. with his election appeal before November 8th. You have seen and heard both candidates. You have read about them. Now, in exclusive appearances before the newsreel camera, each sums up the reasons why he should be elected.
This is Senator John Kennedy, the Democratic nominee for the office of the presidency. The 1960s presents our country with great opportunities and great challenges. If we're going to successfully move through the 60s, if we're going to be true to our destiny of being the great defender of freedom in these dangerous times, then the United States must build its strength. We are a great country, but I believe that we can be a greater country. We are a powerful country, but I believe we can be a more powerful country. The Democratic Party in its past years has served the people. Social Security, care for the aged, housing, human rights, all these have been the products of the liberal tradition of our great party. Now in 1960, in these dangerous and difficult and challenging times, I believe that the Democratic Party can lead again. I believe we can get this country moving again. I ask your support in this election on November 8th.
What is the most important issue confronting the American people in this election campaign? There's no question about the answer that I have found in traveling all over this nation. Above everything else, the American people want leaders who will keep the peace without surrender for America and the world. Henry Cabot Lodge and I have had the opportunity of serving with President Eisenhower in this cause for the last 7.5 years. We both know Mr. Khrushchev. We have sat opposite the conference table with him. We know what peace demands. We will keep America the strongest nation in the world, and we will couple that strength with firm diplomacy. No apologies, no regrets. Always willing to negotiate for peace, but never conceding anything without getting a concession in return.
Both ask you to inform yourself, to think, and to get out and vote.